So yin yoga.
So I'll tell you a little more about the yin practice, how it's working, and also we could keep on talking about Kali and her transformative power. We'll end up with a yoga nidra session, which is a very powerful practice. If you're seeking for change, also it's very good with the Kali energy. And we'll go through some deep hip openings. Hope you'll enjoy it. So we'll start with the diamond pose. So I invite you to bring the soles of your feet in front of you. And once you're here, make your feet further from your pelvis. So it's forming a diamond shape, a square shape. So we don't want the feet to be too close from us. We want them to be resting nicely further away. And I invite you to, maybe it's a choice, there are several options here. You might use a bolster here, and maybe you can put your bolster here or two bolster, and then walk with your hands. Try to make a little space with your buttocks. You know, sometimes there are some ligaments on the way, and then release your upper body on the bolster. You're not forced to use a support, you can also just relax your upper body here with no bolster. So you choose the option that sounds the best for you. Yin means everything that is contrary to yang. And yang is more like the sun. It's all that is warm. It is active, masculine. And yin is more of a feminine energy. It's the moon energy. It's more, yeah. So everything according to the Taoist philosophy, and yin yoga is a mix between the Taoist philosophy and the yoga philosophy. And according to the Taoist philosophy, everything has more or less of yin and yang inside itself. So this practice is meant to be a complementary practice to the more yang practice that we usually do, the more active practice, the more like the asana practice we did this morning. And the idea here is to work on the deep tissues and on the ligaments and the articulations of the body to create space in the body. So what is really important here is trying to relax completely your body in every pose we are going to do. Once your muscles are relaxed, then you can start to create space in your articulations. because otherwise the muscles, the role of the muscles also most of the time is also to protect our articulations. So as soon as they contract, then we protect all the articulations. So here we just want the opposite of that. Important principle in Yin Yoga is, according to this principle of trying to go and to work to the articulation, we have to stay quite a long time in every posture. Usually the body takes 1 to 3 minutes to relax in a pose, depending on your practice. So we need at least to stay that time, that long, in a pose, so the body can relax. And then, eventually some space will be created in the targeted area. Another principle of Yin Yoga is that we are going to try to stay still in every posture. And then, so the idea is also here to, once the body is still, try to implement a very quiet, deep and profound breathing. No ujjayi, just a very, very soothing and long breath. So if we achieve stillness of the body, stillness, a quiet breath, then eventually the mind will also quiet. It's also a very strong practice on the mind. Here also try to completely relax your legs, let your knees getting naturally open. Try also to relax your arms. Fingers. Try not to use them to hold yourself, but more try to use the weight of your body, your upper body, to relax a little more. I mean, if it's too hard on your neck, you can add block, or blankets, or bolster. Make sure there is no tension in your forehead, in your jaws. one big inhale, one big exhale, and slowly with your hands, and use your hands to roll your way up very, very slowly. Take all the time you need, millimeter by millimeter, inch by inch. Together, feel very slowly, gently, no rush. And let both of your knees go side to side. Release the inside of your thighs and hips. Open your legs. You don't need to go very far. It's also very important, and I will talk to you through that in yoga. It's not the intensity of the posture that is important, but the time you stay in that will make the space in the bottom. So you don't need to go very far away. So if you want to see space created, but you have to stay a long time. So here we're going to do both sides. So first maybe we can put our right arm either on the floor if it's fine for you, or on a block. But you can also use a bolster here, which might be more comfortable, or two bolsters, or block and a bolster, whatever. Take one big inhale, lengthen your left arm to the sky, and then release your left arm over your head.
Yeah.
So it doesn't have to be pretty, or we don't try to open our heart like we do in Hatha Yoga here, but just it's more about stretching the side of the body here. So you can completely release your shoulders, your neck. And keep on breathing. So the principle is to stay still in every pose. But there is, of course, two moments when we, three moments when we can move. First moment is when, of course, we change posture. Second moment is when maybe after the body is completely relaxed in the posture, maybe you can sense that there is a little more space in the body. And then if you feel that way, maybe you can go a little further in the pose by putting a block on the side, or depending on the pose, maybe blocking your hands a bit forwards. And the third time is the moment when you feel you can't relax in the pose. So this might be a signal that you're going too far in the pose. And if this is happening, then you can completely add more traps and step back a little in the pose. relax. If your neck, shoulders, face are relaxed, every once in a while, check how is your body. Are there any tension somewhere? Is there a part that is hard to relax? If this is the case, maybe you went a little too far in the pose. Anything at all. What we're looking for is kind of the middle path. When we are feeling something. Find a Goldilocks point, neither too far nor not feeling anything. And if this is too much on your neck, you can keep your right arm relaxed here in front of you. did it here. Kali is also the goddess of time, reminding us times change and our perception of time might be very different. Hard time to relax here, you can maybe use your breath to help you here. Trying to release a little more on each exhale. Especially if you're feeling something under your thighs or inside your hips. And remember, nothing forces you to go beyond what's acceptable for you here. We often tend to go a little too far because we want to achieve goals. We want to be more flexible or fitter or whatever. What puts us in this type of state of mind is our ego. And the ego always desires more. So here you can use one of this Kali's Siddhi, Kali's power, to get a little bit of your ego. And instead, what you practice with kindness. And maybe go a little less far. Take one deep breath here.
help you through center. Pose called shoelace. Actually, the yin yoga poses have a different name than from the hatha yoga or vinyasa yoga, because we don't want you to or us to confuse them, because the intention is completely different. So here in hatha yoga we call that gomukhasana, but here it's called shoelace because we can make our shoes from here. So we'll start with the right leg under, and you can bring your left leg over your right. So if this is too hard on you, no problem, you can lengthen the lowest leg and work from here. So you bring then your left foot toward your buttocks and do the same here. From here. If you have a knee injury, you feel something is going bad here, you can fold a blanket and put it here, or the bolster might also do the job here. And same as usual, we're going to walk with our hands. Release the upper body on the mat. You can, of course, use your props if this can help you to release your forehead and your neck. A lot, or you might feel quite not a lot, depending on your body shape. So if you don't feel anything here, you can bring your feet forward toward the front of your mat a little more. So this is going to deepen the work of your hips. Otherwise, keep your heels toward yourself. Meridians. As you might know, philosophy comes from China, and so does Chinese medicine and the wisdom of the qi energy. So every yin pose has effects on the meridians, on some meridians. And every meridian is related to an organ in the body. According to Chinese medicine, the liver is, in between others, related to our anger. How could I build a class with this quality of Kali? Like, of course, this is the angry goddess, so maybe we might work with anger. Remember the story of Kali that Nuria told you this morning. She is this fierce goddess with a black skin and a tongue, rolling tongue. She has lots of weapons in her hands. And when she's asked to destroy the demons that are destroying the earth, she has to eat them, which is quite violent image. She has to eat the demons so they don't reproduce themselves. Especially when we are yogis, we're supposed to be zen all the time. This is the first thing people tell. so you must be super zen, super relaxed all the time. Don't worry, I'm angry too. And so I think there is bad anger as well as there is good anger.
Observer and someone watching a movie or a play. And once you are able to observe the pain, not to identify yourself.
are not the pain. You are not the emotion. You are not your anger.
Every
painful situation has an end. This is what Yin Yoga is teaching us also. That's great news. You can just sit, lay down on your back and put your feet mat width apart and bring one knee, then the other to the center of your mat. So you're releasing the inside of your thighs, your buttocks and hips, and just do this several times. Also massaging your buttocks.
Poison.
And there is also good anger. The anger that leads to creativity, to change, to transformation. The anger that Kali is inspiring us. Gandalf, Lord of the Rings, because Gandalf, at one point when I think they are in the mine, I don't remember the name of it, and Gandalf says this very famous sentence, he said, "You shall not pass." And this is a very healthy and fair anger. Because Gandalf is trying to fight the dark forces of Saruman. And that anger, it comes from unfair situations, it comes from things that are not in alignment with our own truth. This might be a very powerful and creative anger. And very, very slowly. Take one big breath first, and very, very slowly. Use your hands to roll up. And come to square pose. So you just need to open your knees on the sides, keep your bent knees, ankle to knee. So try to really put your ankle over your knee, so it's more working on the hips more than the ankle, because otherwise you're going to work on your ankle. And it might be useful, but we are more looking for opening the pelvis. So try to do that even if it's a little frustrating, because the leg might be a bit upper. And the same, you completely can lengthen the lowest leg and do the same. You can use support under your legs, that's completely fine. And gently walk yourself down. Gandhi. You know, I think that if he wouldn't be angry in the first place, angry at the situation, seeing his country being colonized by England, and he wouldn't have seen anything unfair or whatever that would have led him to be angry, he would probably have never started his non-violent movement. change the situation of India, but also bring a great change in the world. Transformative purpose. May arise when we need to change something. Transform ourselves and maybe the world. Gandhi was also saying, be the change that you want to see in the world. Some of those movements, or stay a little still here, so you might maybe even make your feet wider if comfortable, or maybe bend closer. But we're going to stay here for a few moments. Knees, your knees are resting on each other. you can relax your arms on your side, palms facing up. Enjoy sensation. Maybe here it feels like your hips and thighs are a little lighter. Maybe there's a little space here. Maybe it feels completely terrible. With what is now.
Under your head with a blanket. You can also do yoga nidra on your side in the tiger, the tigress, the I don't know how you call the woman of the tiger in English. Tigress? Oh, really? Okay.
Oh.
So tigress pose is like you have one arm laying here, palm facing up, and you have the upper leg that is resting on a bolster on the side, and you can also use a bolster or a folded blanket to support your head. That's also an option. Just see what's nice for you, and if you choose the tigress pose, make sure your shoulder blade is not on the way. So yeah, exactly.
welcome to Yoga Nidra. Welcome to yourself. Welcome home. So if you still have some arrangements to make in the posture, please do so. Remember, sometimes very small changes can make a big difference. So don't hesitate to add a prop or maybe put one prop out of the way. We'll stay quite a long time here, so make really sure that you won't feel any discomfort during the practice. So release your whole body on the floor, on the earth. So here we'll try to achieve the desire of zero movement. This is the ideal state of Yoga Nidra. But if you see a desire to move coming at one point in the practice, observe this desire. Maybe it will eventually fade away. But if it stays, then please just move with awareness in the goal to make yourself more comfortable. Feel the points of contact between your body and the floor, or between your body and your props. Again, feel yourself supported by the earth, Pachamama, the nourishing mother. And then note that you're breathing. Observe your natural breath coming effortlessly out and in your nostrils. And maybe if this is more comfortable for you, maybe you can exhale with your mouth, if this is something you're used to. Or just keep the breath with your nostrils. Then every exhale, feel that your body is getting more and more still. Every exhale, let your body go a little deeper into a relaxed pose. You're now in a safe and secure place to practice the state of consciousness that is Yoga Nidra. Completely relaxed body with a conscious mind. This is Yoga Nidra. And you can now pronounce to yourself 3 times, I am practicing Yoga Nidra. I am practicing Yoga Nidra. I am practicing Yoga Nidra. You can now bring your attention to your heart. And from here, try to make rise a feeling of gladness and enjoyment. Gladness of being able to practice Yoga Nidra now. Being able to have time for this practice, to make space for this practice. And feel that your heart is fulfilled with this sense of joy and gladness of just being here. And as you would put a seed in the soil, you can now pronounce for yourself your samkalpa, your resolution, your resolve. A positive sentence for yourself. Something that you wish for yourself or for this practice. Something that will come natural to yourself. Don't try to look too much for it. Something very easy and natural. And you can now pronounce for yourself this samkalpa, this resolution, 3 times. Grow. We are going to put our attention on our body. And here also we won't try to analyze too much what's going on. We just going to put the light of the mind's attention in the form of a bright little star. So we'll use the image of the stars to scan our body. So you can imagine that your body is the black sky, and every part of the body will have a little star on it that we are going to put. And every star will shine and twinkle every time you put your attention in on this area. So we'll start by putting one star in the middle of our color box, in this little hole, small hole in the middle of our color box. One little star on our right shoulder, and one bright star on our right elbow, right wrist, one star on our thumb, index finger, middle finger, ring finger, little finger. One bright twinkling star in the palm of the right hand, and one star on the wrist, right elbow, right shoulder. One little star on your right ribs, and one star on your right hip. One shining bright star on your pelvic bone, and then one star on your right thigh, right knee, right shin, big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, fifth toe. And one star on your right heel, calf, kneecap, under your right thigh, right buttock, right side of your lower back, right side of your middle back, right side of your upper back, and again, one star in between your collarbones, shining with the light of consciousness. One star on your left shoulder, left elbow, left wrist, left thumb, index finger, middle finger, ring finger, little finger, and one shining, twinkling star in the left palm, left wrist, left elbow, shoulder, left ribs, left hip, one shining, bright star on your pelvic bone, left thigh, left knee, shin, big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, fifth toe. One star on your heel, left calf, kneecap, under your left thigh, left buttock, lower back on the left side, middle of the back on the left side, upper back on the left side, and then back to the little hole in between your collarbones.
One shining star at the tip of your tongue and the tip of your nose. Two beautiful stars on your eyelids. One star in the middle of your forehead. Your third eye. And let this star shine a little more maybe than the other stars. And then one little star on the top of your head, back of your head, and then back to the little hole in between your collarbones. Now sense that all those bright shining stars are creating a beautiful constellation. The whole body is twinkling with the lights of conscious awareness. Your whole body is filled with lights of conscious awareness. And now we can put the image of the stars aside. And come back to your breath. On every exhalation, feel that your body is getting heavier and heavier. Every exhalation, the body becomes heavy. Feeling of heaviness in the whole body. And then on the next inhale, feel like your body is very light. It's so light that it could start to fly. Feeling of lightness on every inhalation. Body super light. And now see how it would feel if you could bring those two sensations together. On the inhale, feeling very light, and on the exhale, feeling very heavy. See how it would be to feel those two sensations at the same time. Heaviness and lightness at the same time. Feeling very grounded and very expansive at the same time. Feeling this expansion of the body at the same time. Stop with the sensation here and come back to your breath. See how the breath is coming in and out of your body without any effort. It's a very natural movement, smooth. And you can now put the breath aside and bring your attention back to yourself, your laying self, your self laying on the ground. Observe yourself just the way you are in the present moment, right now. See how you're dressed, which posture you are. Try to visualize your present self. Observe yourself with compassion. In a very friendly and compassionate manner. And then, as if you were watching a film backwards, try to see yourself in the previous hours. What were you doing? Just before this yoga nidra practice, but also before, a few hours before. And see yourself yesterday. What were you doing yesterday? How was yourself yesterday? And go even more backwards. Last year, what and how was yourself last year? And do so at each point of your life to analyze the person you were before. And pose at each of these moments that seems important to you. And greet the person you were with warmth and kindness. And pose as far as you want to go. And try to observe yourself at this point in the past with all the details you can. So, acknowledge that this person you were in your past is your past self, and face this person, and as you say, you're about to say goodbye to that person, smile to him or her, and this past self will give a gift to you, saying, carry this with you, it's precious. And as you receive the gifts, you walk away and you hold this gift to your heart. And see yourself walking now to the future, to your present self. And as you walk yourself to the present person that you are, greet
rate the changes that happened to you? Meet all the previous selves that you used to be. Honor each of those selves with great compassion and love. And finally, you arrive at the present person you are now. And once again, see yourself laying down here on the ground. See yourself with your clothes, how you're dressed, how you are laying down on the floor, in which posture you are. See yourself very clearly. And gently approach yourself and put the gift you're still carrying on your heart. It's a magical gift. And the moment it arrives in the here and now, in the present moment, the outer package disappears. What remains is a powerful feeling in your heart, a sensation of warmth and tenderness. You feel spacious and free. Everything that truly matters about the essence of your true nature is here now. The gift from the person that you once were is the gift of freedom to be who you are now. You inhabit the present moment completely and give thanks for it with the consciousness of who you are and how free you are to be the person you are. And you can now come back to your sankalpa, your resolution. And you can tell for yourself this resolve 3 times. Three times repeat your resolution, positive resolution. Which is going to happen in your life. And now you can come back to your body, sensing your body laying on the floor. And you can tell yourself, I have been practicing Yoga Nidra. I have been practicing Yoga Nidra. I have been practicing Yoga Nidra. Come back to your breath. Notice that you're breathing. Come back to your sensations. You can start to move gently your toes, your fingers. Maybe more your head side to side. If you need to stretch, please do so. The practice of yoga nidra is now over. Hari Om Tat Sat. And when you feel ready, you can roll on your side and come back to sitting. Thank you.